So, looking at exercises 1A, I'm just going to get a clear my, there's something, a quick useful hint. If you want to clear your max window, click on the clear all button at the bottom of the window and it gets rid of all that. It's a little bit bigger. Actually, I'll wait for a minute. Okay, so, from the exercises you were asked to do, you might decide to follow along with this while you do the exercises. I think that's just as valuable a learning method. So if you think that that's better, then by all means follow the video and follow the exercises at the same time. That's no problem. okay, so the first thing you're asked to do is to make this rather dull little patch here, and this kind of reinforces some of the things that I introduced in the first sort of 0-0 tutorial. We have a message box at the top here. We have a print object, and the print object prints the message from the message box in this screen over here. Again, you might remember that what we have here is a message type, which is a list. So this actually contains a variety of different items, which might be commands, it might be a variety of different things, all of which get sent at the same time within the same message. We will later on find out how you can split a message from a message box into independent messages, but that's something for later on. Anyway, if I've got the patch locked, so if I click on that message box, the message just gets sent to the max window, and as we know, you can keep doing that and it will keep sending it. So that's very straightforward, that one. On to the next one. Sorry, I've got a frog in my throat. And open that up. Right. This time we've got a few more objects, introducing the toggle, the integer box, and a metro object, which again, from the first tutorial, or the tutorial 0-0, you might remember that the metro is essentially a metronome, and it outputs a certain message at regular intervals. Now, the intervals are, this is before you do anything, you touch the interface at all. The intervals are dictated by the number that you put in here, and this represents milliseconds. So, excuse me, there are going to be pulses sent out from Metro, or messages sent out from Metro, every 1,000 milliseconds. And so if I click on the toggle box up here, you will see that that's exactly what happens. It's 1,000 milliseconds, which of course is 1 second. The toggle box in this instance, and again you might remember that the toggle box sends out a message of a 1 when you have the cross in it, and a 0 when you don't have a cross in it. So, but it will only change once. It only sends that message when you actually click the object. And the 1 when Metro receives it is understood as a message telling it to start, and a 0 when Metro receives it is a message to stop. so that's one issue. And then on the other side, you have a number box which is being connected to the right hand side. And this one dictates a change in the number of milliseconds between each individual pulse. So if I drag this up to, well, you can see it changes immediately. So now if I put it to 500, I have to mess about with this for a minute. There we go. This now should send out a pulse every 500 milliseconds. So that's half a second. So this time a number is being used to determine the regularity of those pulses. And in fact, I could put in, if I click on that number box and I write in a value, so I could put in 200, then that changes immediately. What else? Okay, so I talked about the inlets, and from what you've just seen, you will notice that they are connected to different inlets. So if I unlock the patch using Command E and I hover over this inlet here, you will see that the little message that pops up is metro start stop metronome. So we know that connecting something to that will receive a message that tells it to either start or stop the metronome. On the other side, you've got a different message which says metro set metronome time interval. So to say really that the inlets all do different things. They are not interchangeable. You can't connect. I couldn't connect this number box to this side and this toggle box to this side in order to start or stop the metronome or to send it those values. It has to be connected to the appropriate inlet because that's basically how the object is set up. Similarly, if I hover over the outlet, we'll see output ticks of metronome. So the metronome is sending ticks out of that outlet. So what's it mean by ticks? Well, if I add a print object, so I'm going to use my little shortcut of N and go to print, and I connect that to there, you'll see that it's outputting a bang, and that is its tick essentially. That's the message that it by default it will output. I just need to lock this again and then turn that off. And that bang, if you remember, tells the object that receives it to do whatever it does. Well, the object that's receiving the message from Metro, so down this line here, is the button object. And the button object, when it receives any message, flashes. It also flashes if I click on it. Okay. But at the moment, that's not actually connected to anything else, so the message won't be bypassed through it. It just stops there. But when it receives a bang, when it receives any message, it does whatever it does, which is to flash. So the bang message, if you remember again from tutorial 00, the bang message is a do whatever it is you do message. It's simply a trigger to trigger the function of the object that receives it. what else can we do here? Okay, I'll unlock again. This time I'm going to connect to the toggle object, which is over here. It's the second version of that. What I should say, I could have connected the print object to any of these outlets to establish what that particular object does. So if I were to connect from the toggle object, lock the patch again, and then turn the patch on and turn it off, you can see exactly what the toggle object is sending. And this is what I mean when I say that the print object is very useful for diagnostic use, for establishing what any particular object is doing. So if at any point in a patch you want to know what an object is doing or what an object is outputting, then connect a print object to it. Do this before you start panicking that you don't understand what's going on. If you're meticulous and you're methodical, you can add a print object to one object. So I could do it to the toggle object. And then I could, once I know what that object is doing and how it's how it's interacting perhaps, or what message it's sending to the next object in the chain, I can get rid of that and I can connect the print object to the next item in the chain and see what that's outputting. And when I know that that's outputting, well, in this case, it's outputting bangs, as we just saw. So I can delete it from there and I can connect it to this object and see what that's outputting. Well, we haven't actually seen what that's outputting yet, so we can try that. Well, essentially, it's actually just throughputting the bang that we sent to it in the first place. And not all objects just throughput. They might actually do something with the data that they're being sent. But in this case, it's just throughputting the bang that we received before. and then I can unlock the patch again and connect the print object to the next item, which is the toggle there. I can lock the patch again and try that once more. Okay, so this time, and this is what I was coming on to next, we established that a bang that's received by a toggle object tells the toggle object to do whatever it is that the toggle object does, which is to toggle, i.e. to move between two states. So between zero, between what? Well, if you look at the graphics, it's kind of between off and on and off and on. But in terms of what it in turn is outputting, it outputs 0 and then 1 and then 0 and then 1, with each consecutive message or bang that it receives.